Poppy hair that this was going to be crazy, and I feel like these teams have delivered. I can't say I've had anything to do with it, but that's Tristana coming through. We got a Tristana Rell bottom lane, Ornn in the top lane, boring, who cares, but he's fighting Pantheon. That's exciting.
And that's Azir always finds a way into the meta. Kai's level two.
It's like Kaiser finds a way to engage. Jezu's now going to be in trouble, but the exhaust is there, and they're now trying to turn him burn. Karzu's exhaust is now falling away, and he's going to be in trouble. Treats walking forward, the auto. One more. Where's the cadence at? Oh, the thumbs up, but is it enough? Yes, it is. And now Kaiser has to run out to safety, but that's a second flag and drag. Jezu also on the way in. Hail of Blades is back up and available. One, two, three. He's stacking him. Kaiser's going to be in trouble. He's burning. He's running away. He's forced to dismount and just
the Drake
barely
secure that one. SK for now holding in the 2v2. They do have a slight CS advantage, but Twisted Fate now level 6 has the ignite thanks to the Unseal Spellbook.
Janet has been very consistent, has been that massive contributor, and it's important for him to remain that in this game because bot lane is in trouble. Karzi just getting absolutely deleted, exhaust right on time, Blue joining the party as well, and the mad bot lane is getting dissected clean from SK.
Wow, beautiful. I think SK would be more than happy to take that fight.
Karzi, no. We have three people in the area. They're just going to try to one-shot Karzi before the fight even kicks off. Calista flashing off to the side. They get the knockback, but no, she can't quite fall into spears. The ignite is ticking. Karzi's still alive, and Jezu is ticking down. Jezu will live as well. Karzi now in trouble. That's going to be the flag fadeaway coming in from Treats. Dunking on him in style, but Kaiser and El-Yoyo are still healthy. Humanoid, all eyes on the Azir. The slide, the glide, maybe the ultimate coming in as well, but Treats with a perfect stopwatch. The TP now coming into TF, matching the pressure coming in from the Azir. Gold card could come out. But
Kaiser are hyper-aggressive. They love going for 2v2 kills, they love fighting you, and they love opening that bot lane up. Honestly, a comp where it doesn't do a lot of magic damage. But I definitely think they come up with some creative ones. This is another engage.
Humanoid gonna leap out to safety. Jezu with the pullback, gonna throw Jarvan right back into the mix. A lot of ultimate burn down there, but El-Yoyo, you're gonna flash out. They've used the exhaust as well. Blue now stepping forward. That's a gold card. Kaiser most certainly gonna get taken down, but here comes the Ornhorn. Maybe the turn. His Arma coming in. El-Yoyo running forward. Run. Trying to make his way out of the fight. Oh, Arma gets taken down though. SK are just too strong in these early skirmishes.
And they just execute with perfection. They just kind of stayed at arm's length of Mad the entire time. That engage underneath the tower was really good timing. They forced multiple summoner spells out from Humanoid, El-Yoyo, and
SK
5-0, 4k gold lead. They're going to get their first Drake of the game. I'm impressed, Drakos.
And I think when we look at both of these teams roster with an almost completely new lineup.
Now, of course, there is some context there. Of course, Mad chosen to go for a strong side on the top side of the map. But Kaiser coming to help out Humanoid, offer a little bit of assistance. Look at that poke coming out from the Jarvan.
Yeah, and also
the flash right now. You know, you want to try and be as proactive as you can on the map. And while SK are taking objectives, Mad are successfully trading objectives elsewhere on the map. They were able to get the bomb.
Proves that they can go toe-to-toe with the top.
Here we go. This is it. This is it.
We're going to dash into safety. Gold card going to go in. Humanoid in trouble, but an instant cleanse. The exhaust coming in as well. The flash coming in to extend the range of the EQ, and Humanoid will go down. But now the TP coming in as well. Arma can recommit to the fight if he wants to. Treats backing off. It looks like just the single pick for SK.
This is exactly what I wanted to see from SK. Abuse the fact that Humanoid doesn't have his flash up. Yes, you get his cleanse, but there's so many point and click CC speaking of.
Here you go. Udyr time, baby. Run, stun, job done. Gen X trying to make it out of safety. Aegis Assault and pulling back to his team. It's clean movement for now, but Karzi going to close that one out. Treats goes gold. His Arma butts his head into the wall. He's unstoppable now, but now Kaiser in the midst of the entire team. Karzi leaping face first into danger, though, as Jezu's just going to finish the job. Karzi, that is not the fight that you wanted. That is one strong Calista, and
it comes through from Kaiser. It looks so beautiful, but there's no stun available.
Gold lead
to put Mad into a difficult situation, and Armor has no TP, so they should be able to burst this one down.
Stoning, Kaiser going into the middle of the entire line of 2k, getting lower, eyes on the Baron, dropping slowly, the fight continuing to go through, but no, Tinks is going to grab it in the end, Karzi leaping into the backside, but he immediately gets one shot. There is no room for this Tristana in this game. Humanoid in the back of the pit is going to leap over, the knockback is there, and SK just descending upon the Mad Lions. It is Predator versus Prey. Arma, just another name on a list for this team as Jezu gets the triple and El-Yoyo.
SK really liked the commitment to the Baron, forcing Mad in, and they knew that Arma didn't have TP.
And sadly for him, it's a similar story in this game where Jezu and Treats are absolutely popping off. 6-0-5. Zerelda's Grudge now finished, meaning that all those abilities are going to slow. There is zero way.
Very difficult champion to make work, but SK have done a great job. And just, again, this is a very difficult to execute
comp. Mid prior, they don't have bot prior from the side of Mad, so if they want to force a fight here, it's a very big gamble. The initiation, though, El-Yoyo just trapped in the pit with the entire team. Keep your eyes on the Ornhorn going in, though. That's already one member down. Karzi going to get deleted right off the bat one more time. Kaiser trying to buy as much space as he possibly can, but Humanoid already going to go down, too. They don't even need the Spear to connect. double kill coming through. Yes, Mad can team fight, but not in the face of a 10k gold lead.
Once again, a beautiful fight from SK. They knew what they had to do, and they just focused one target at a time. Mad were uncoordinated, and SK were able to punish. A sub 30 minute win coming out from SK. They're looking to come into week three strong.
Stunning performance from the SK lineup, and most certainly the SK bottom lane. Fantastic across the board, and good to see a young lineup like this coming together in the matchups that matter most. Mad Lions left reeling in what was an incredibly dominant victory for SK Gaming. 3-3 tied up with the Mad Lions.
That's all I can say. I am